Hello, my name is Chris Backus, and I am a teacher of the young adult and college class at the Southside Church of Christ that meets at 1655 West Manchester in Los Angeles. Today, I'd like to bring a lesson to you about making the most of life through endurance. Quick question, did you hear about the rose that grew from concrete? Some of us know that poem and are familiar with the message of that poem. How in the world would a rose grow from concrete? That is not the soil that is needed for a rose to grow. However, if we see a rose that's grown from concrete, we know that it had to endure some things to come out as beautiful as it is and something that we can enjoy. Well, we're going to use as an example today to look at how we endure and identify ways that we can make it through and the benefits of endurance. That is our lesson aim, to identify the benefits of endurance and identify what we need to endure. Let's take a look at our first scripture. Psalms 1, 1 through 6 says, "Blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law doth he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of the water, that bringeth forth his fruit in season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind driveth away. Therefore the ungodly shall not stand in judgment, nor the sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knoweth the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish." Let's take a look at this Psalms. Questions on the text. What reasons is the man described in Psalms like a tree planted by the rivers of the water? Well, think about it. A tree by the water symbolizes being close to the resources needed to prosper and endure. Therefore, we know that the tree will not fade because the tree is constantly being fed by the water, and therefore seasons come, seasons go, but the tree never fades. What is the message to us? We have to be close to our source, and our source is Almighty God and His Word. His Word is what feeds us constantly to help us endure trials and tribulations, good times and bad times, and endure the thoughts that we even have. Because if we're thinking properly through the Word of God, God is helping us endure the stressors of life. And lastly, in that text, he says, how are the ungodly described and what is the contrast to the life of the righteous man? Well, the psalmist describes the ungodly as wheat and chaff. Basically, chaff is that, if you see in that picture, that small puffy stuff on the wheat stalk that blows away at any blowing of the wind. We know that it has no roots. It's not grounded in anything. Therefore, when challenges are coming about, it is pushed with those challenges instead of enduring those challenges like the wheat stalk. Let's look at another scripture, Revelations 2 and 10. This is a message to the church members at Smyrna, where it says, "Fear none of those things that thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. But be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life." What's the difference here between unto and until? Think about it. When we go into a room, we don't walk into a room until you reach the door. We stop and go into the room, synonymous with walking unto. You don't stop when you're faced with death or trials. You go unto those trials and death, and even if death has consumed you, you stay faithful. That's the message to the church members there. Now, what are some of the benefits of enduring? Because if we don't know the benefits, why would we even try to endure? Well, let's turn to 1 Peter 1, 3 through 10. Let's read some of the text. And the benefits I want you to see that I have highlighted in each one of these scriptures. Blessed be the God of the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, which according to his abundant mercy hath begotten us, and again, unto a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled, and that fadeth not away, reserved in heaven for you, who are kept by the power of God through faith unto salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. So in these first three verses, we see God has given us mercy. He's given us an incorruptible inheritance that's reserved for us in heaven, that is going to be revealed to us in the last time, wherein we should greatly rejoice. Though now for a season, if need be, ye are in heaviness through manifold temptations. Yes, we're tempted in a temporary state, but we should rejoice knowing that we have an inheritance that is incorruptible. That the trial of your faith, being much more precious than of gold that perish, though it be tried by fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ. Saints, we have to go through something. Just like gold has to be purified through fire, our faith has to be purified through endurance and trials. Whom having seen not, ye love, in whom though ye see him not, yet believing, ye rejoice with joy unspeakable and full glory, receiving the end of your faith, even the salvation of your souls, of which salvation the prophets have endured and searched diligently, who prophesied of the grace that should come unto you. We're going to be tried by fire, but we should even be joyous in those trials, knowing that the salvation of our souls is the end of our faith. And we get that salvation because of the grace of God that he gave to us. In conclusion, if you want to endure some things, you have to keep this in mind. Romans 8:35-39 says, no matter what you go through, who shall separate us from the love of God? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? And might I ask, or coronavirus? As it is written, for thy sake are we killed all the day long. We are counted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither life nor death, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things to come, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus. Endure. These tribulations don't last always. Remember, we have an eternal salvation, which is in Christ Jesus. And I encourage you to be in his word, to be fed daily with the resources he has for us. God bless you.